One of the adjectives that always comes up when talking about The Undertaker is your loyalty to WWE, and that you stayed through the toughest of times. What would have happened had you taken an offer from WCW in the late 90s? Is that something you ever truly entertained? Or obviously it's a lot of rumor and it hasn't been coming from you. So there's a lot of stories that have been told. What could history have looked like?
I don't know. I don't think it would have turned out like this. You know, I had that character, which was so strong. There's no way I take that character to WCW.
Right.
You know, and then whatever I do at WCW, do I bring it? I can't bring that back. And do I pick the old? See, those things, all that stuff in a lot of people's minds, that doesn't matter to people. That's not the way I looked at things. The Undertaker was part of me. You know, I just couldn't imagine. I had the business sense of mind, like people go and they come. I mean, I can't tell you how many times I've seen guys leave and come back and do all that. I never could get a visualization how that would work. We were struggling and it was just like this, it got worse and worse and worse. And it was like, yeah, there's a lot of guys who are calling me, you know, like I was talking with when Kevin Nash was there, you know, and he was like, man, I'm pretty sure, you know, we get you some pretty big cheese if you want to come down here and do this thing. Yeah. And of course you're thinking, cause you're miserable. But then it just like, there's two things. One, I remember, and you've probably heard the story about me before I came to WWE when I was still in WCW and I went to renegotiate my contract. You know, I wasn't looking for a big bump, but just, you know, I'd been there for a while. My contract was coming due. I figured that I could get off of that minimum deal. You know, so I went in and they offered me the same deal. And I was like, well, I was hoping for a little bit of a bump. And, you know, I was still, you know, I only had a few years in the business, but I had a pretty good year there for them. And looked me square in the eyes. And they said, Mark, you're a great athlete, but no one's ever going to pay money to watch you wrestle.
Wow.
That's a true story.
Wow.
Jim Herd, Ole Anderson, and Jim Barnett. They were all in the room and I was there and I was just like, well, that's pretty much the writing on the wall for me.
Right.
I'm not going to stay here and then, you know, turn into fodder for, you know, these other guys. And you know, that really lit a fire as well. But what Vince did, and he never promised me a thing other than opportunity. That's all he ever promised me. He said, I'll give you an opportunity to do something. And then he gave me that character. And then, you know, it was just like, yeah, this is, I'm going to, you know, when it came down to it, at the end of the day, I said, this is whatever happens, good, bad, or indifferent. This is where I'm going to be. And, you know, if ship went under, I was going under with it. And even if the WWE had gone under, or, you know, which is, you know, that Vince would never let that happen. I mean, they're just,
right,
you know,
right.
You know, I could have went to Japan. I could have went to anywhere, you know, place like that. I doubt that I ever would have went back to WCW when it really got down to it.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.